Hello and welcome. Welcome and hello. Today is Thursday, which means that it is vlog day. And this morning I woke up and I felt, let's rewind a little bit. Super Bowl Sunday. There's people and dip and hard root beer. We're all hanging out and just enjoying the show. And then the end of that night, we decide we need to go get some froyo, you know what I mean, to celebrate the win of the Denver Broncos. And so we go to Yogurtland, and I'm feeling good, and we're walking around, and we go to Yogurtland, and I crush, like, a bucket of froyo with, like, you know, those little cheesecake pieces that are just, oh, their God, they're so good. And then at that moment, when I had finished my froyo, it felt a little bit of a little tickle in the back of your throat. And I was like, that's weird. I did drink a lot today and I haven't really had any hydration. So I'm going to drink some water now. Maybe this will mellow out a little bit, right? That little tickle in the back of your throat that every once in a while you're just like, that's how I felt. This morning, I woke up and I felt just awful. Do you know that feeling where it feels like you're in a hot tub that is like perfect body, like perfect room temperature, like a lukewarm hot tub, like not cold and not warm, but like, God, just like you don't know where your skin ends and the air begins. Like, that's exactly how I felt. And I was like, wow, this is weird. And I sat up out of bed and I was like, I'm feeling achy and bad. So I did some work. I uploaded some videos. I jumped in the shower, got out of the shower, felt a little bit worse. And then as the day has been progressing, it's just been getting worse and worse and worse and worse. And it's not like a head cold or anything, because I can breathe through my nose, and it's not a sore throat because I can swallow, I can swallow liquids just fine. And my cough has basically gone away. It's this really weird, like the lukewarm hot tub, but more as it progressed throughout the day, it was like this, you know, when you live in Southern California and it's 86 degrees outside, but you still feel cold. And so what you do is you lay on your couch in a blanket and you're like shivering and you just want to get warm, even though the breeze coming in your windows is just melting hot. Like on any other day you'd be like, turn on the AC, bro, but not today. Like, you feel like you want to turn on the heat. That's how I felt all day today. And I'm laying on the couch and I fall asleep for a couple minutes and I wake up, I answer some emails, I answer some comments, I'm binge watching like The Office, which I've seen before, I just like rewatching it. That was my day. And so it gets to be later here, the sun goes down, and I'm like, all right, here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to go into my office right there. I'm going to get all my shit together. I'm going to suck it up a little bit. We're going to do a quick little vlog. I still feel awful. No runny nose, no cough, no sore throat. I can't really vape because it like feels a little bit weird in my body. I've been vaping like a little bit here and there, and I'm going to attempt right now, believe it or not, to do a vape-free vape vlog, which is unheard of on the YouTubes. But thank you. Thank you for joining me. Thank you for bearing with me. The more I thought about it, there was just so much stuff that I wanted to say, and that's weird, right? That's weird. There's some advocacy stuff happening. Here's how it's going to go. We're going to, off the top of the program, I got some announcements. We got some advocacy stuff like that at the top of the program. There's a New Jersey flavor ban. There's a city in Canada that has straight up banned online sales. So there's some advocacy stuff at the top of the program. We are not going to have any beer. I'm going to do a minimal amount of shout outs. I do have a bunch of first impressions, which we're going to talk about, but not vape. I'm going to announce the giveaway winners right after the first impressions. I'm going to not have any, pardon me. I've been drinking water all day, so I'm getting a little bit burpy. I'm not going to have any retro vaping, even though I have some great retro vapes right now. I went through and cleaned a bunch of stuff, and I have a special box that's just retro vaping that I'm oh so excited about. No retro vaping this week. No reviews for things that never got reviews. We're going to finish it off with my favorite comments of the week, and then we're going to call it good. I'm going to go lay on the couch for the rest of my life, and hopefully by next week, I'll feel a lot better, and we can pound out some videos, we can pound out some vlogs, we can get back into the way that normal things work here on the Grim Gearing YouTube channel. If this is your first time joining me in the vlog, like if one of your buddies was like, dude, you don't watch the Grim Green vlog? And you're like, no, should I? And your other buddy's like, yeah, dude, it's like my favorite thing to do in the week. You should really check out the vlog. And you're here now, and this is your first vlog you're watching? I apologize. This is not generally how it goes. I generally feel better. I generally do beer tastings. I generally vape in a vape video, but not this week. There might be a little bit of vaping in there, but not this week. So moving forward, let me get out my vlog notes, which, as we all know, are always out. So I just wrote down with the sickness. So that was that whole story, down with the sickness. So there's one thing I wanted to mention real fast before we get into any advocacy, before we get into any what I've been vaping, this, that, and the other. There's been a lot of people messaging me talking about their Double Helix Design drip tops, right? And the problem that they're having with their Double Helix Design caps is that they're actually melting them. So I use a DHD Double Helix Designs Jess Marie drip top, this cap right here that I use in basically every freaking video. And I use it generally on the Indestructible, on the Noisy Cricket, which is a series box. So the heat that you're getting from your coils is a little intense. It's high voltage, high heat. Now, in my experience of using these on a series box, I have never come close to melting them. And people will email me and they'll be like, I melted my Jess Marie, or I melted my Double Helix Designs, you know, cap. It's warped now, it's melted now, and I'm like, I'm thinking in my head, that is so weird to me. I've never come across that. So if you're a person and you're going to use the Indestructible or the Dot Mod or something, some atomizer on the Noisy Cricket with a Double Helix Designs cap, just be aware that your vape is probably going to be a pretty hot vape. On a series box, you want to stay above 0.3 ohms. There's no reason to go below that. Generally, I like to stay around the 0.4 to 0.45 resistance range on a series box. It's still nice and warm, but it's not blazing hot. Additionally, you have to take harder drags on a series box. You got to keep those coils a little bit cooler. So, high heat, don't melt your drip tips. I can't even really put together a thought right now, but just be careful. Be aware that series builds are hot, especially on series boxes, unregulated boxes like the Noisy Cricket. So this, I'm not even going to try to vape, but I do absolutely love those caps. So I got an email from a guy named Rod up there in Canada. So Rod messages me on my email and says, sorry, I don't know if you received my last email. This is just a heads up that Quebec, Canada, has stopped the sale of juices online. As you can see in the email below, can you please get the word out to our brothers and sisters in Canada and elsewhere? Thanks, brother Rod. Now, I don't know how Canada works. I don't know how the prime minister or whatever governing bodies they have up there works, but he forwarded me an email from a company called Fresh Air, based out of Montreal, Quebec, Canada. Fresh Air's closing sale. Hi, everyone. As you probably know, Fresh Air is now closing its operation. The province of Quebec recently issued a new bill forbidding online sales of e-juice. With that said, we have some inventory that we would like to liquidate. And they go through and they list, we have 40 bottles of this, 100 bottles of this, 50 bottles of this, 50 bottles of that, 50 bottles of that. If you are interested, simply reply to this email. First come, first serve. We'll take transfers of PayPal. So this is something that I didn't know about. This is something I can't really get any solid information on as far as vaping in Montreal and the lack of online juice sales. Evidently, they just banned it. They just issued a bill forbidding the online sales of e-juice. I can't really find too much about this online. In fact, I can't find anything about this online. The only thing I can find that is related to Canada and vaping that is current is Bill 44 got passed, and it will be going through in May, and it places limits on the places that you can vape. So under the law, smoking on the outdoor terraces of Montreal bars and restaurants will be prohibited, despite bar owners protesting this, that it will cut down on their business. That's the only thing I can find is the usage ban. I can't find the sales ban. If anybody has a good link for me, let me know. I'll throw it in the description. I'm running out of steam fast, so I'm trying to get through some of this stuff, but thank you, Rod, for sending that over my way. Now, the last little bit of advocacy that we have to talk about is who sent this to me. A fella named Kyle sent this over to me, and New Jersey has a ban on flavorings that's about to happen. It's S-298, New Jersey take action to oppose flavor ban on vapor products. So, Bill S-298, pardon me, which would ban the sale of vapor products in flavors other than tobacco, clove, and menthol, is on the move in New Jersey. Predictably, the Senate Health, Human Services, and Senior Citizens Committee, which is chaired by the bill's author, Senator Joseph Vitale, Democrat, passed S-298 with a favorable vote. The flavor ban proposal now moves onto the floor of the Senate for consideration. So please send a message now to your state senator telling them, urging them, not telling them, you always ask, you always urge them to oppose this bill. And CASA has some links all ready to go for you. You can send a message, you can share this on social media. I'm urging all the West Coasters and all the New Jersey people, Vapor City Girl Mimi, although you're not Vapor City Girl anymore. You're I'm fucking Mimi. Mimi, M-Turk, other New Jersey vapors, get on this. Let's get on this. I mean, this is, you'll be illegal to sell anything that doesn't tastes like tobacco, clove, or menthol. Interesting that they threw clove in there. That seems really interesting to me, considering one of the things that got me into smoking was smoking cloves. So, bah, what are you going to do? There you go. So, New Jersey, let's take some action over there in New Jersey. So, we're getting through this vlog. Slowly but surely, we're getting through this vlog, my friends. I have some stuff that I'm going to be talking about in the future when I'm feeling a little bit better, including recycling juice bottles. We're going to be talking about my tattoos. There's a bunch of other stuff that's coming up, and we don't have any beer this time, so what we're going to do is jump straight into the shout-outs. So real quick, before we get to any shout-outs, I just want to talk about what I have been vaping, and I haven't been vaping it a whole lot today. There's a couple things over the last week that I've been vaping pretty regularly. Vapor Flask Classic. This is from the Vape Forward Wismec line. Vapor Flask Classic. It's just so tried and true and reliable, and I love the shape and I love the buttons on it. This is the Mutank from Origin Vape. This is filled with Grim Cult Caramel Corpse, and it's just been fantastic. I did have some struggles with the Mutank initially wicking it, but it seems to have helped trying different methods, and I think I got a wicking method down, so when I go to review it, that's what we're going to talk about. We're going to talk about that particular wicking method. Should I try to vape it? I don't really even want to try. There you go. There's a little bit of vapor. That's what we call a little bit of vapor. So, next thing I've been vaping, of course, this is the Axis Vapes M17 Dot Mod Petri version 1.5 with a very, very matchy drip tip. This is YIG in this, and I have a 0.14 dual-fused Clapton at 105 watts. It's a great vape. This one is the first one that I had to stop using because it is really throaty. When I get sick like this, I get this like hypersensitivity to smells and tastes. And so your juice never tastes better, but you can't vape it because you will cough. I don't really even want to try to vape this. Let me give it a try. Yep, that's intense. That is a throaty juice when you're sick. One of the other things I've been vaping, Joytech Cuboid. This is the Cuboid, right? Cuboid 150 watt, and we're going to be talking about this in the first impressions. This is the new CCI Mouse tank from Cloud Chasers Inc. This tank just fucking blew me away from the second that I vaped on it. I can't wait to do a review for it, but we're going to be doing a first impressions this time. It's been pretty phenomenal. This is, I don't even remember what juice is in here. I'm sorry. I usually link down in the description to everything I talk about in the vlog, including mods and juice and RDAs and beer and advocacy and all that stuff, and I don't remember what juice this is. And I don't want to vape it because I know that this is throaty right now. Son of a bitch. So, I think that's all I'm going to do for what I've been vaping. I think that's all I'm going to do for what I've been vaping. So thank you for joining me for that segment. Now, let's do a couple quick shout-outs. It is shout-out time. So I got a somewhat mysterious message the other day, a mysterious email. And even though the person's name was on it, this person addresses me and says, "Hello, Nicholas Green. My name is Legion Anonymous. You have pleased Anonymous by having facts behind your videos with the Kasaw call to actions. If you would give Anonymous a shout out in your next vlog, that would be in your best interests. You do not want to anger us." You're absolutely right. I do not want to anger Anonymous. I'm glad that the collective of Anonymous is pleased by my videos. Boom, there you go. Fist bump it, you beetards. And I have just been pounding so much water. This is my sweet 7-Eleven Captain Phasma water bottle. I literally love this thing. I've been pounding water, and each one of these I've been drinking with a packet of Emergency. I've done like 5,000 milligrams of vitamin C today. I don't know if it's helping. I don't know if vitamin C actually even does anything. For some reason, I don't think it does anything, but mentally it helps me out. Plus, it makes your water a little bit tastier, so I don't feel bad drinking it. So moving forward from there, oh, I almost forgot. Shit, I have an Irish shout out to do. Totally forgot. Hang on, Scribbles. I got you, Scribbles. Don't you worry about this. So Scribbles is a guy I met while in Ireland. Scribbles and his very sweet, adorable girlfriend, they run a vape shop up in, Ireland. I can't think right now. I literally can't even think right now. It's called Vintage Vape Rooms. And anyway, he writes me and says, this is on Instagram. He writes me and says, "Hey, dude, how you keeping? I was wondering if you could do me and our Irish vape fam a favor and shout out an event we are putting on next month. It's called Cloud Sessions 2, and it's on the 18th of February. Is this even going to get out before the 18th of February? Oh, yeah. So we got a solid week before the 18th of February. Cloud Sessions 2, and it's on the 18th of February, hosted by Vintage Vape Rooms and the Vape Cafe. Ronan has been helping us every step of the way, and it's really gathered some momentum over the last couple of weeks. It would be really cool if you could mention the event in an upcoming vlog. There's an Instagram page, Facebook page, and a website for the event. Please give it a look and see what you think. All the best, Scribbles, Rachel, and the rest." So there you go. I'm going to track down a link for Cloud Sessions 2, which is going to be in Dublin, Ireland, sponsored by Vintage Vape Rooms and the Vape Cafe. If you're wondering who Ronan is, he's one of the organizers of the Ireland Vape Fest Ireland, which I am so excited. I could not be more excited to get back to Ireland this year. I know it's just going to be fantastic. So moving forward from there, this girl's name is Rachel. How do I zoom in? Why can't I zoom in? Okay. Rachel writes to me and says, "Hey, Nick, my name is Rachel, and I work at a small mom-and-pop shop in Allen, Texas. The owners, Stephanie and Jean, opened the shop to help everyone out there that are still smoking cigarettes. They opened August 2014, so they're still fairly new. They are kind and humble people that I would do anything for under any of their circumstances. Since I started working at their shop, I've met all kinds of vapors, from the just starting out to the I just want big clouds. Every customer has their story on how they quit smoking, but one in particular really stood out to me. I can't remember her name at this time, but she is the sweetest and funniest elderly lady, and she shared her story with me, a stranger. 2 years ago, she was diagnosed with cancer. One of her lungs collapsed, and she was in the hospital for a while. The doctors told her she could never have another cigarette because the risk was just too high. So she asked about alternatives, and the doctor gave her the generic nicotine gum and patches. Well, she asked about vaping, and her doctor told her he hadn't heard about any risks, so she should try it. She now comes in the shop twice a month for her new coils and her new juice. Her cancer is just about gone. Her lungs are back in working order, but she still has to get her chemo treatments. Every time I see her, she has the world's biggest smile on her face. Customers like that make me believe in what we do as a vaping community. Thank you for taking time to read this essay. Absolutely. And it's funny, Rachel actually didn't even ask for a shout out. That's just a story she was telling me, but I thought that story was so great. So shout out to you, Rachel, and the owners of the vape shop in Allen, Texas, Stephanie and Jean, and also the little old lady whose name apparently nobody knows. You are absolutely shouted out. Wish you nothing but the most success and health and happiness that you can possibly have. So moving forward from there, Allison. Allison writes to me and says, my name is Allison. Actually, the first thing she says is, hey, Grim, which is how like 99% of the emails start. Hey, Grim, my name is Allison, and I have a favor to ask. My boyfriend is a huge fan. He watches your videos every day after work, and I mean every day. I have to go in the bedroom if I want to watch anything, or even sometimes I just watch along with him while we cook dinner every night. His birthday is coming up on November 15th. Missed it. Sorry. And I was hoping you could give him a shout out as a gift. I'm also going to be ordering him one of your shirts as well. His name is Joe. If that, I'm going to omit his last name, but it's Joe. Joe, if you're dating Allison, you know who you are, Joe. I'm writing in advance in hopes that you would be able to fit him in. Thank you for keeping him inspired to stick with vaping. Before we got together, he smoked about 2 packs a day, and now he vapes, and he has for almost a year now. I don't even smoke, and I bugged him to at least try vaping and even bought him his first starter kit. Now he's into all the mods and building his own coils, etc. Thank you in advance. Have a great day, Allison. Absolutely. Allison, you are shouted out. Your man friend's name, whose name I can't find. Joe, you are shouted out. Thank you for watching the vlog while you make dinner. It's funny, someone posted on Twitter, you know, last week I mentioned, post a picture of you watching the vlog while you eat dinner. And I was like, does anybody even do that? I'll be damned. People posted themselves pictures of watching the vlog while they eat dinner. It was bizarre. Guy had a really delicious looking burrito. So let's get on to my last shout out here. Muriel. That's strange that these are all shout outs from females. Maybe if you're a girl, you have a higher chance of getting a shout out. Hi, Nick. Yes, you can say our names in the video. Thank you, Muriel. My name is Muriel, and my husband Scott watches your videos and your vlog constantly. He is coming up on his 1 year vapiversary on Valentine's Day, and I'm coming up on my 2 years. And I wanted him to have a shout out on your vlog for his birthday. It's March 1st, and he doesn't ask for much, and he would be super excited to be shouted out. I'm doing this as a surprise, and I'm hoping he understands how proud of him I am for kicking the stinkies and sticking with vaping. It took me over a year of trying to get him to stay with it, and he finally did. He has helped both of us breathe better and live better lives. Thanks for having awesome videos. And keep up the great work. Your fans, Muriel and Scott. Oh, I almost forgot. I met you at VCCPA, and we got a photo with you, and my husband had to ask because I was too afraid. Well, Muriel, you never have to be afraid to meet me ever. You walk up, you say, hey, and then I go, hey, and you go, you're a person, and I go, I am a person. You're a person as well. There's no reason for this to be awkward, but Absolutely. Muriel, you are shouted out. Scott, you are shouted out. I have a problem getting people's birthday shout outs like close to the day of their birthday. I'm either a month behind or like, I'm either like 3 months behind or a month early. So happy birthday on March 1st. Just bookmark this video, come back on March 1st, and then rewatch it so that you can you can have your birthday shout out. Absolutely. I think, you know what? I think that's going to do it for shout outs. I did want to give a really quick shout out. Where are you, fella? Where are you, guy? This guy wrote, and his name's Mitch on YouTube, and he wrote, we did some quick sciencing at my shop the other day and found out that the Vapresso coils will work in an Atlantis as well as the Triton 2. So they should work in any tank that takes Atlantis coils, like, say, the Silo Beast or the Super Tank, and yeah, the flavor on these coils is pretty damn good. Thank you, Mitch, for the heads up on that. You know, I had a couple people asking me what those Vapresso coils also fit into. Evidently, they are compatible with the Aspire Atlantis products and are compatible with any Aspire Atlantis compatible product like the Silo Beast. So thank you, Mitch, for sending that my way. What we're going to do is wrap up these shout outs. I have to get to some first impressions. All right. Yeehaw. Well, holy shit. First impressions. What are we going to be talking about in this first impressions? I put away my vlog notes for some reason. First things first, Twisted Triple. Vaping with Twisted 420 has a freaking mod. Did anybody know about this? Well, it's true, and I have one. And it's called the Twisted Triple because it's a triple 18650 unregulated box. I'm 100% sure that this is being made by Whoa Tofo, and it's a lot like their Chieftain mod, but this one is a triple 18650, so all these are running parallel. So battery up, battery up, battery up, and it fires. And there's like a color code in here. Do you see this little light right here? There's a little light that happens there, and that changes colors. It goes from white to blue to yellow. I believe that is to gauge your battery life, which is kind of interesting. I thought I really would be into triple 18650 unregulated mods, and then it turns out that they're just not super comfortable to hold. I haven't come across an unregulated triple 18650 mod that is actually really comfortable to hold. This one's a little bit wonky. I've got pretty big hands, and I have to like hold it with my pinky and hold it all together, or hold it. I don't know. It's just, it's small for the size. I mean, it's small for the batteries, but it still feels a little big. Now, topped on this is the Tsunami RDA from Geek Vape. So this is basically a Kennedy clone, a Kennedy 22 clone, but with a velocity deck and an adjustable airflow, right? That just right away, that sounds like a great idea. It kind of is a great idea. I built some coils on here that are ridiculous. This came out to 0.08, I think, and I really only feel comfortable using this build on a triple 18650 unregulated box mod, so we get that amp limit up. But it's a really nice vape. I'm not sold on the top cap on this, but it seems to work okay. I'm just going to try to vape it. This is my hodgepodge mix of Oasis Mist and Glacier Banana. I don't think I'm going to be able to vape this. Shit. Okay, stop vaping, Grimgrain. Stop vaping. But yeah, it's got the exact airflow of the Kennedy 22, but you can close it off a little bit. Oh, and it gets a little bit louder, and you can close it off. Oh, and it gets even louder. I wonder what happens if you close it off even further. No, nothing happens. Nothing happens right there. These O-rings are pretty nice. They work pretty well. I've actually really been enjoying this little combo right here. I'm not 100%. So for Vaping with Twisted 420 to release a mod, I was expecting a little bit more fun with it. Vaping with Twisted 420 is a fun guy, and as it stands, this is just a black mod. It says Twisted Triple, and it's got his Ninja Turtles logo on it. And that's it. That's it. It's just a triple unregulated box mod with his logo on it. It's not even that big. I don't know. I was expecting something a lot cooler. I don't 420 blaze it, so the 420 is a little bit lost on me. I don't really want to be walking around with a mod that says 420 along the side of it. But if you do, that's cool. I'm not, believe me, I am here to judge nobody. So blaze it. But I don't partake, so feels a little awkward walking around with a mod that says 420, vaping with Twisted 420 on it. But that's that. I'm going to post a link in the description to the Twisted Triple where you can check it out if you're so interested. And like with all my first impressions, I'm going to be spending a lot more time with this, although not as much time, because I've had the Watofo Chieftain for a while, and this is leaking. Holy fuck. This is leaking all over the place. Okay. Great. That's great. I like it when you drip and then juice is all over your mod and then all over your button. That's just my favorite thing of all time. This is a lot like the Chieftain. It's got the same exact button. My Chieftain button was not amazing. And this one you have to actually, like, I don't know, feel like you have to press it hard to get it to fire. But moving forward from there. So I want to talk about not this mod. We're going to talk about this mod next week. This is the Cloud Maker. It's a LiPo DNA 200 that the door just comes right off, and there's different doors on here. But what I really want to talk about is this RDA. This is the Achilles. My most sincere apologies for the coughing. This is the Achilles RDA, and if you ever wanted like a hypercharged velocity, this is the hypercharged velocity. I have 4mm around dual fused Claptons in here, and they can take some freaking wattage. I've also been using this new cotton that I do want to talk about more next week. It is the Kendo gold cotton, and I actually really, really like it. It's really, really interesting. So this is the same, works on the same principle as the velocity. The top cap screws and unscrews so you can open those juice flows just to an obscene level. I mean, obscene, like you're breathing. Or you can screw this down and close them down a little bit tighter, which is where I like it. It comes with its own drip top, big hole right there. But their cap has that honeycomb pattern in it, so you can't drip through it. And that's really what bothers me about this, is you can't drip through it. I've been using it with the Easy Dripper, and so I want to just be able to take my Easy Dripper and go bleh and just drip through the drip tip. But if it has that honeycomb cap on there, you can't. I have a Cherry Vape drip tip on here, and this is the Striker Juice on the money. Quite delicious. This is 0.2 at 119 watts, and should I try to vape it? This vape has actually been a little bit more mild, so I'm going to try to give it a toot here. Oh, yeah. Oh, I miss vaping already. It's been a couple hours without vaping, and I miss it. I miss that flavor. Now, what's great about this is there's notches cut into the base and notches tabs on the top so that you have to line these up with the base. But once you do that, it will always align your airflow holes right directly with the coils, and it grabs the base so that you can unscrew it and screw it down easily without it ever getting stuck ever. And when you adjust this, the airflow, the base will stay in place and it won't spin on an O-ring. It's a really well thought out RDA, and it is honking. These are only available on eBay. I'm going to post the link in the description to where you can check it out. Let me get to my Achilles. Yeah, so this is only available on eBay right now. It says it's a 28.5 millimeter authentic Achilles RDA, better than the Temple Buddha Tobe. There you go. $60 plus free shipping. This is a pretty rockin' little RDA. I have been getting along with it really well. I'm gonna try some smaller coil builds in there, some that aren't quite so ridiculous. These 4mm coils, they really really are big. I mean, I've never used coils this big, and they have been working just fantastically. So let's have one more toot here. I feel like that's angled down. Anyway, let me have a toot here. I'm sorry, I'm talking to myself. I'm delirious. Don't worry about me. I'll be fine. Oh, that is a good vape. Oh, that is a really, really, really good vape. Ah! So, moving forward, what other first impressions do I have, Grim Green? Oh, the new Anarchist phenotype. Where did you go? Holy shit. Phenotype Bell came out last year. Mountains of airflow. Nice big two-post build deck. And now Beyond Vape, Aria, and Anarchist have released a new cap for it. So this is the new cap and this is the new chamber. Now, this is top-down airflow, right? It's a lot. A lot like that Aeolus. A lot. It's a little bit more like the Watofo... What's that thing called? The Sapor RDA. It's got a mountain of airflow. I don't necessarily like this cap, although I think it looks cool. It's not ideal to put in your mouth. It's just, I don't know, it's a little bit weird and stumpy. This is definitely going to make me cough. This is a 0.39 at 90 watts, dual fuse Clapton. So the airflow goes in and down and then up. That's the idea behind this. It's a leak-resistant cap that you can pop off, paint your juice, line these up, and go boop. All the O-rings are really nice. All the tolerances are really nice. Now, these are not terribly expensive for these new caps. If you already have a Phenotype L, $25 will get you the new control sleeve, they're calling it. I think it just looks super cool. Ow, fucking hell. Now, let me talk real fast. That splattered in my fucking face and pissed me off. This KangerTech 120 is a piece of shit. I'm going to be doing a review for it soon. It does not. It's got an insane lag on the switch. That's like a 3 count before it fires. Additionally, I have this set to 90 watts. I do not believe that this is delivering the power that it is promising me. It's supposed to be giving me 6 volts. It does not feel, taste, or otherwise like 6 volts. This stupid Kanger thing is upsetting me beyond repair. But here's what we're going to do. We're going to move on with our lives. Let me have a toot here. Wow, I'm surprised that didn't make me cough. This is my buddy John's banana bakery juice, and it's freaking delicious. I really, really like it. These Fuse Claptons have been holding up awesome, and strangely enough, I have somehow been able to vape these dry, and I don't know if that's because of the airflow or because of this, that, and the other. Obviously, more science is needed. I do like that it doesn't leak when you put your juice in there. I do like that it doesn't leak. Nope, second to last thing on the agenda. Sorry, this is the Cuboid. This is the mouse from CCI Cloud Chasers, Inc. Now, I did Kurt from CCI dirty. He sent me a tank and I never reviewed it. And then I felt bad, so he's like, he texted me and he's like, should I even bother sending you our new tank? And I was like, you know what? I'm going to make this up to you. Yes, send me that new tank. I'm going to vape it. I'm going to review it. I'm going to put it out there for all of YouTube to see. This is the CCI mouse. And this thing just fucking rips so hard. It's ridiculous. I almost said another R word. It is ridiculous. Now, this tank thrives on high VG juice. I put some 60-40 in here. It was only 60% VG, and I had some leaking issues. So I went, okay, this tank needs high VG juice. So I put some 80% VG juice in here. I believe this is the Dude Juice, the Jade. Put some higher VG juice in here. Have not had a leak, have not had spit back, only obscenely delicious flavor. Now, this is a 0.55, it's 78 watts. You could run this, let me check the 510, but I get the vibe that you could run this, oh, that's a solid 510. I get the vibe that you could run this on a series box with absolutely no issues. I'm going to try to take a toot, even though I know this juice is a little bit throaty. Sorry, Squid Dude, it is a little bit throaty, but only when I'm sick. Nope. God damn it. It's too throaty. It's too throaty to vape. I wish I could show you the performance from this thing. Let me try again. Can't really appreciate it unless you're here, but the performance from this is just ridiculous. Now, it is a juice hog. I have been filling this up constantly. Literally, I vaped this all day yesterday, and I probably filled it up 7 times, 8 times, something like that. I'm going to post a link in the description to the mouse from Cloudy Collaborations. $49 gets you a mouse, airflow control, protruding 510 pin. Yes, it's okay to use on hybrid mods. Super baller top fill system. Come on, Kurt. No more spilling e-liquid all over yourself. Pyrex tank spacer to prevent heat transfer to your mod. Pre-built vertical coils. Capacity of 4 mils, 22 millimeter diameter, 66 millimeter height. It's good, and it does have a really easy fill system. The way that Kurt showed me was you close off the airflow, you open the top, that's it. And you take your juice, and I'm going to demonstrate right now because I like doing the bleh sound. It is now the universal sound for filling up your tank. Bleh. You just top it off. Squeeze, 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 squeeze. Squeeze, 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 squeeze. Top it off. Top it off, mother trucker. Then you cap your bottle. You put it away. You line up the little nubbins, and you press it in and twist. Then you reopen your airflow, and oh, no spit back, no fucking juice in your mouth, no flooding, no nothing. This tank loves high VG juices. I can't say that enough. If you're going to go pick this up from CCI, I hope you have a lot of high VG juice. Just a little rock star. So this actually came in just today. Now, this is the new 200-watt TC device from Vaporesso. And you know what? I really like the Target. I love the way it looks. I love the way it feels in your hand. They have come out with the Taro, and it looks effing cool. This camera is not going to do it justice. It feels effing cool. The tank, the new tank, uses the same C-cell coil heads, so it's kind of nothing to write home about. They just added top airflow, which I'm generally not a fan of, but we're going to try it out anyway. I have Rig Reserve Influx in here. This is the one vape that I've had today that has not made me cough, believe it or not. Now, granted, I'm only... Why is it saying check atomizer? Okay, I'm only running a 0.44 ohm coil at 40 watts. It's giving me 4 volts. So this is a mellower vape for right now until I feel better. And then clouds, bro, clouds. All I get is delicious flavor. This juice isn't throaty. This is the one juice I've been able to vape. And thankfully, I have it on a sweet new mod. Now, it only supports temperature control in nickel and stainless steel, which I think is weird. When you go through the menu, it goes from wattage to nickel to stainless steel back to wattage mode. And there you go. No button rattling. It feels like a freaking hefty, sturdy mod. I'm a big fan of this. I plan on using this just a whole bunch. Sorry about the vaping, but this is one of the only things I can vape, and it's delicious. So obviously, yeah, I'm gonna need to spend way more time with this. It's got a little tab cut out right here. There's where your batteries go. This is your other cap. This feels not like aluminum. It feels a little bit stronger than aluminum. I doubt it's stainless steel, but it feels very, very sturdy in the hand. 4 magnets, keeps it on. Fit and finish is just stellar. My ring doesn't light up when I press the button. And I want it to because it looks like it lights up red or orange, which I think would be really, really cool. I love the white-orange combo. I want a white-orange tank for this. Anyway. That's going to wrap up all my first impressions. And seriously, everybody, thank you for bearing through me with this. I apologize that this is going to be a short vlog. What we're going to do now, after those first impressions, As always, let me give my disclaimer. I'll have links down in the description. I'm going to spend way more time with everything I do a first impressions for before I feel comfortable talking about it on YouTube. I just like to spend time with devices, get to know them in and out, get to know the little quirks, see if anything breaks or malfunctions or is faulty, because things can happen when the first month that you own something. So that's what I'm going to do with all these first impressions. So let's wrap this vlog up. Let's get to some favorite comments of the week. I just start reading the comments of the week and it just makes me chuckle like you can't imagine. Fellow named Wicked Out on Instagram, and I'm comfortable posting his name because his Instagram is private anyway, but I did a post for that new Horizon Tech ceramic thingy that you re-wick by wrapping cotton around it and putting it back in the tank. And he left a comment on that picture on Instagram that says, "Oh, now you're pushing this shit few weeks back. You did. Oh, don't vape this, lol. I got an email, blah, blah, fucking fake ass, $$, grabbing people." So I'm assuming he thinks that just because I posted a picture of a new Horizon Tech tank that I'm somehow on the take from Horizon Tech and I am somehow getting money from posting a picture, which could not be further from the truth. I just thought it was something interesting that I wanted to share with the world, and that's how Instagram works. So I'm sorry that you feel that way, Wicked Out, but I certainly have a container of dicks that you are more than welcome to consume. So, moving forward from there, I got this guy. Now, this guy, MP Vapes, I just thought it was funny. Just a funny comment, not a derogatory comment, although he did use the word honky. He wrote, "Good vlog, honky. I'm curious to know what you've bedazzled your clutch hat with." I didn't bedazzle my clutch hat. I don't know what you're talking about. I truly and honestly don't know what you're talking about, MP Vapes, but thanks for the chuckle. Maybe don't go around throwing the honky word around there, but that's fine. Do whatever you want. I don't care. I'm not here. I'm not here to police YouTube. You can do whatever you want. Now, lastly, this comment of the week, I don't remember what video it was, but it kind of just made me chuckle, and maybe this guy was trying to get into the comment of the week, but if he was, then absolutely mission accomplished, Mr. XHead75. He wrote, "Don't let no motherfucker drop a dick in your vape budget hands." What? What on earth does that even mean? Don't let no motherfucker drop a dick in your vape budget hands. I feel like I need to get that printed on a shirt or something. Just grim green and on the back in big letters, it just says, "Don't let no motherfucker drop a dick in your vape budget hands." I don't know what that means. I don't know if that's a recurring issue for him, possibly. Maybe there's some sort of story going on there that we don't know about. But there you go. Favorite comments of the week. So you know what? I'm going to end this vlog with the giveaway winners. Giveaway winners. And I don't have any sort of, intros or blah, blah, blah for the giveaway winners, this, that, and the other. But a lot of people entered. I mean, just well over 1,000 people between Facebook, Twitter and Instagram and this, that, and the other. So before I announce the winner, I want to show you some of my favorites, and they will be compiled here in a smooth jazz-based slideshow. Thank you. lot of really great entries. The guy replicating the sour face from my video, I thought that was hilarious. But there can only be one winner. And one guy, I just liked his picture, and I went over to his Instagram, and I feel like I like this guy without even knowing him. On Instagram, he goes by Trouble On You, and the picture he posted is really disorienting. It looks like I'm blowing vapor through his monitor. I don't know how he timed this so well. I'm hoping he had help, but I'm blowing a cloud, and it looks like it's going through the monitor and out into his room. If only that were like really a possible thing, that would be amazing. But he wrote, "It is Thursday, which means that it is vlog day, Grim Vape Blog Vape to life." And that's it. You're the winner, Trouble On You. If you are Trouble On You, then I will contact you via DM, direct message on Instagram sometime today. And I'm going to need to get your address because you've got a whole fuck ton of vape stuff coming to your house, place of residence, office. I am just delirious. I got the sweats right now. I feel achy all over my body. I am going to wrap this vlog up. I had no choice. You know, there's that famous saying, the show must go on. I don't agree with that, but in this case, I guess, yeah, the show must go on. I wish I could track it down, but one of my greatest inspiration and heroes of all time, Penn Jillette from Penn & Teller, he had a radio show on CBS Radio Free FM a number of years ago, and he had a great show, a great, great quote about how the show is the last thing that should be important. And I think it was referring to 9/11 and Broadway shutting down their shows for a night, and everybody was freaking out, and they said, no, the show must go on. If the show doesn't go on, the terrorists win. And he was saying that is ridiculous. It's okay to step away in a time of mourning, or in my case, sickness. The show doesn't necessarily have to go on. But thank you so much, everybody, for hanging out with me for this brief little vlog. I am going to plunk down on my couch. I'm going to binge watch The Office, and I'm going to eat ramen noodles and drink vitamin C until it is literally coming out of my genitalia. I don't know why I said that. Did I mention that I'm only slightly delirious? I got this new microphone set up as well. I got a stand so that I can kind of swing my microphone around. See how it's on a stand here? And I think that's going to keep down on like the table bumping because it's on its own stand, which it's great. This is great. I'm going to keep using it. But that's what I got, everybody. Got a lot of tanks, mech mods. No mech mods. I don't really have any mech mods coming up. I did get that new mech mod from Kennedy, and we're going to talk about that next week because I haven't even used it yet. But I got a lot of mods, tanks, and RDAs coming up because, you know what, damn it, that's what vaping is. I will see you all at Vape in the Sun in Arizona. Hopefully, it should be a really, really fun, really, really fun time. I'm going to sign off now, and I'm going to get some help. Thank you. Thank you from the bottom of my heart. The fact that anybody has sat through this vlog shows me who my real fans are. I want to fist bump all of you. I love you from the bottom of my heart. I am a crazy person right now. Thank you so much for watching, everybody. And as always, boom. I don't know. Let's keep on vaping.